If you are recording scripted videos, then it's easy to take your script into YouTube and create closed captions. That's not only for people who are hard of hearing, but for people who speak English as a second language, need to watch with the sound off, and the real gold, it counts for SEO so that Google can understand what your video is about. I'm Brighton West, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to take your script and add it as a closed caption in YouTube. So with all great things as a creator on YouTube, you're going to start by clicking your avatar in the upper right-hand corner and then clicking on Creator Studio. And I want to thank my client, Bon V Weight Loss, for letting me use them as a sample today. And then you'll find the video that you want to close caption. And you can click this down arrow here and click Subtitles and Close Caption, or click Edit and then Close Caption. But you'll get to this screen. And you know, soon after uploading, it's going to publish these automatic captions. But they're pretty good, and you could go through and edit each of these to make sure. Let me just show you what these look like. So you can see here that, you know, they're not too bad, but they don't have any punctuation, they don't have any capitalization. There's, you know, a number of mistakes in here that you need to fix, but you know, instead of doing that, what we're going to do actually is go in and we're going to take this one offline. So we're going to go and unpublish those existing captions. And then let's go back here to subtitle and we're going to add new ones. And this is in English. We're going to overwrite those English subtitles from before. And what we can do is transcribe and auto sync. Now, if you have a existing subtitle file or transcription file that has all the time code built in, you can upload a file, but we're just going from a script. So we're going to transcribe and auto sync. And then we'll go over to that script. This one's in Pages. And I'm going to Control A to select everything and then Control C to copy it. Then I'll go back to YouTube and I'm going to Control V to paste the whole thing in here. So we know that all the that there aren't spelling mistakes and whatnot in here because this is the exact script that Sharon read from the teleprompter. The next thing we're going to do is push set timings. Now, this is going to take probably a few minutes. This is a 6-minute long video, and you can actually watch this little bar go across the bottom here. And if everything goes well, then that bar will go all the way across and your timings will be finished. But sometimes that bar gets stuck and your timings are finished. So in that case, what you'll do is head over here to the little wheel here to click Set Timings and click on that. And when it's finished, it will allow you to see those timings being set. Before that, it'll give you a warning message saying that timings are still being set. So what you'll do at this point is go through and play the video and just make sure that the words that are being said are matching up on screen, and they're not, that they didn't really set the timings incorrectly if there's big gaps or stuff like that. So let's go ahead and just give that a try. Okay, so it looks like we were off a little bit on the script here. So this actually we're going to change. Perfect. So this is working out really well. I would go through the entire video. You can take these little blue bars and move them back and forth if the timing wasn't right, and you can come over here and make any changes that need to happen if some of the words might be off, if things changed a little bit in the final production. But that would be it. Watch through the whole thing, make sure everything comes across properly, and then click Publish. And now those will be available for people to turn on by clicking the little CC icon here in the lower right-hand corner of your video.
You could also transcribe your script inside YouTube, but these days I'm more likely to allow YouTube to auto-transcribe my video, then go in and fix the problems, add punctuation, and then publish the polished video. I found that it takes about 3 minutes to polish one video of automatic transcriptions, and it takes about 5 minutes to type 1 minute of text from scratch. And it's even quicker if you already have the exact script to upload. If you enjoyed this video, please click subscribe to get access to all my future videos. Great content for any small business owner looking to use online video to grow their business.